Remember that beautiful planted tank I designed for my betta fish? Well, it ain't paradise no more. See that blue-green slime? That's right, we got cyanobacteria, baby. Keep watching as I talk about what causes it, the natural versus chemical methods I use to treat it, and which one worked the best. Hi, I'm a gamer's wife, here with practical and proven tips to help busy aquarists like you. And all I wanted was a super easy, low-tech, low-maintenance tank to sit back and enjoy when I'm stressed at work. Unfortunately, it's had this reoccurring issue with, well, multiple types of algae, and one of them was blue-green algae, or more accurately, cyanobacteria. No longer was I calm and relaxed when gazing my betta fish sound wave. Instead, his home had become an eyesore and a constant source of stress. Why, oh, why don't you look like the aquascapes on my Instagram feed? Now, there's been lots of studies done on what causes cyanobacteria in aquariums, but nothing's concrete because the bacteria is so genetically diverse and can rapidly spread through practically any ecosystem, freshwater, saltwater, or on land even. Aquarium articles online say it's caused by dirty filters or substrates with excess ammonia. Well, mine measured at 0 ppm. It's normally found in anaerobic areas with lack of flow. Mine started right under the filter output. It could be from excess light. My timer's only on for 5 to 6 hours a day. And then they say that it happens in aquariums with very low nitrates. Oh wait, this other article says it happens when you have high nitrates and phosphates. Ugh, so who's right, guys? Okay, so clearly there's a lot of conflicting info out there on what causes cyanobacteria. What about the remedies? Most people say it's a pain to get rid of and spreads like wildfire. I did find that when I rubbed off some slime from a Buccifalandra plant up high, it landed somewhere down below and started conquering my S. repens. So the natural remedy I followed came from a blog called Aqua Design with the following instructions. Step 1. Manually scrub off the algae from all surfaces, which shouldn't be difficult because it just flakes off in sheets. And then gravel vacuum up as much as possible, removing up to 50% of the water. Step 2. If you have low nitrates, which I did, use fertilizers to dose it up to 20 ppm. Step 3. Turn off any CO2 and use an air stone to increase oxygenation. I didn't have an air stone, so I moved my internal filter to increase flow without disturbing my betta too much. Step 4. Cover your tank with a black trash bag and tape. Keep the aquarium light off and do a blackout for 3 to 4 days. Don't worry, your fish will be fine during this brief fasting period. And step 5. After the blackout, do a huge water change to remove all the dead algae, and then redose your fertilizers back to 20 ppm nitrates. Turn on the light, turn on your CO2 if you have it, and then increase flow to avoid any dead spots. And what do you know? The blue-green algae was gone. I didn't have to use any expensive meds, and the treatment was relatively painless. Until the cyanobacteria came back 6 weeks later. Okay, no more Mr. Nice Guy. I'm going in guns a-blazing. The chemical method I heard was from Aquarium Co-op's channel, and it goes a little something like this. Step 1. Manually remove all algae and gravel vacuum just like before. Check. Step 2. Clean your filter. We're talking the intake sponges, sponge filters, foam inserts, etc. Step 3. Nuke your tank with a full dose of erythromycin per the manufacturer's instructions and let it sit for 7 days. Product links are listed in the description. If you have an extra tank lying around, you can remove any animals, but this antibiotic is safe for fish, invertebrates like shrimp and snails, as well as plants. Step 4. After 7 days, do a large water change to remove all the dead algae. You can continue to do more water changes and even use activated carbon to remove the remaining medication. And step 5. If it's a really bad case, you may have to follow up with a treatment or two. Thankfully, erythromycin will not harm your beneficial bacteria, according to Aquarium Co-op and in my own experiences. And voila! It's been 4 months since the chemical treatment, and I haven't seen any hint of that evil blue-green slime stuff. Sound waves no worse for the wear, and I can finally breathe a sigh of relief and go back to enjoying his tank. Not. So I'm still suffering from this wispy brown algae issue, but I'm gonna do some experiments to deal with the problem head on and hopefully properly balance this tank. In the meanwhile, check out my planted tank tutorials over here and subscribe so you won't miss it when it comes out. Take time to enjoy your aquariums, and I'll see you in the next video.